Hello, my name is Anthony Hall, and in this tutorial we're going to be looking at how to create a basic little 3D room like this, just a basic box, remove the walls, but what I want to do is show you how I would make this little room and also texture it using just one UV and one texture. So what I've got here, look, is the one texture, and in it I've got one UV that I've made to plug in that texture's the whole thing. So just going to go through how to make the basic structure but also UV it, like I said, using one layer and one UV. So let's get started. Okay, so I'm going to start by clicking the box tool and then enter on my keyboard to bring up numerical. Let's make the width 5 meters, the height 3 meters, depth 5 meters. So we've got this box like stuff like this. Okay, drop the selection, space bar. Now what I'm going to do is select polygons from the bottom, and I'm going to select the top, hold shift and select a side and the front like so, and then I'm just going to press delete on my keyboard to get rid of those polygons, so we're left with this outer shell. So I just need to thicken this, so we'll go to multiply, thicken, bring up the numerical, and let's thicken it, say about, let's try 300 millimeters, and what I've got it on is you can have it on instead of normals, put it on contour so we get a nice straight line. So you've got this now, so drop the tool, oops, and the next what I want to do is just want to make a basic window, and just like I said in the original one I shown you, a door. So I'm going to go on a new layer, put our room in the background, use a box, and then let's use this box to make the shape of roughly what I want the window to be. And what I'm doing is I'm making sure it runs through the wall from the outside to the inside, because I'm going to use the Boolean tool just to subtract the positive from the negative. So I'm going to say that'll do for the window. So drop the tool by pressing spacebar. I'm going to go back to my original room and put the box that I'm going to use for the window in the background, like so. Go to construct, Boolean, and then subtract. And then what it does, it subtracts the negative layer from the positive. So what I'm going to do out is I'm going to switch around now. The reason I'm switching around is because I'm going to make this actual box thinner so I can use it as an actual window. So to do that, there's a few ways to do it, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to jump to points at the bottom, and I'm going to select the points, and then in my top view I'm just going to come in, go to move by clicking the T, or you can go to modify move, hold control to stop it going sideways, and then pull it down. I'm just going to pull it just inside like so, and then I'm going to right mouse click and lasso the other two, T on the keyboard, and then bring it in again, so roughly you've got this. So if I turn it on, you've got like the window as well. So I'm going to now select the window, I'm going to cut it by Control X, going back into my main build and Control V, and I'll just call this building. So another new layer, and then let's just do the window. So again, just going to use the box, pull out and up the size roughly of what you want for your door, and I'm just at this minute just doing it by eyesight, then bringing numerical up and making it. I'm just looking at the window and the height of the roof and thinking to myself, how high would this door be in real life, how wide would it be, and so on. And so you do this, you can do the same thing like so. I think it's probably a little bit too thick. Let's go with that. So yep, happy with that, space bar. So now what we've got is the main structure of the door. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy it, Command C, Control C on your keyboard, and Control V, or you can do the same thing here, look under edit, And then what I'm going to do is put the original in the background, and let's just size it down, and we'll size it using the original position and local position, like so. Let's bring it down like so. Let me just move it up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the Boolean again. There's a few ways to do this. Last time I did this, I just beveled it and then used the connect tool. Let's say that, and then I'll go to the points again down here and select them, and let's move it up, not sideways but down and through, because what I'm going to do is Boolean it as again, like so. Let's switch to the stretch tool, hold control and just drag it sideways so it's going through. So again, if we look, it's roughly, you need to just line it up so it's going through, roughly going through the middle, like so. And you can look up here as well, look in your top view. So it's roughly about there. Switching round, and let's Boolean that as well now. So construct, Boolean, subtract. And again, I'm just going to use this now in the background, the original shape to bring in, like I did before with the points, selecting the points and bringing it in. So inside the door frame, and again using the move tool to bring it in, so you've got like a door inside. And let's just bring it up a bit at the bottom so it's in line, like so. So now what we've got is a door with a door frame. Why they're both selected, I'm going to control X and I'm going to paste it into the original object. So now what we've got is the room ready to texture. So just looking at the actual door, it could probably do with moving in a bit because it's overhanging. Look, if you look here, so I'm just going to go to the move tool, hover over it, hold Alt on my keyboard and then my arrow keys to nudge it in, like so. And again, so now what we've got is the door ready to texture. So that's the first part of this video. So thanks for listening, and look out for the second part, which is the UV texturing.